couple of close-ups of some of the stuff here. Looks like they're putting up some more walls in there for the paintings. Okay, now we've got two ladies who are working here at Gavin Brown's. I'm just here to try to sneak a few clips. I'm going to be back for the opening, but I kind of like to set the stage here for this, what obviously is going to be quite a production here for the opening. Would you like to say anything about the upcoming show?
Oh, we just wanted to say that people are just trying to get their work done, and we thought this was being a little disruptive, and that's why we were asking that maybe you...
But I haven't stopped anyone or anything like that, have I?
No, so it's just...
I'm just peeking through the window.
It's just workers, and we really don't want to make them, so we're not going to let you in, unfortunately.
Oh, I'm just going to look through the window, right? I'm not going to walk inside. I can... peek in through the window. That's all I wanted to do.
Okay, but I'm gonna just delete it. Yeah.
So, and I believe this is opening on Saturday. Oh man, they're gonna stick a bouncer on me. Well, this is James Kalm, the guy on the bike. Welcoming back our worldwide viewership. Today we're gonna come back here to Gavin's Brown's Enterprise and check on the opening of Doig. Down here at 620 Greenwich, the very bottom of the West Village. And what a mob scene they got down here. Well, this is quite a scene he's got down here. Peter Doig was actually born in Canada and moved to England. And there's Jules de Bellancourt. And his last show in New York was about 10 years ago. In the 10 years, Peter's actually become one of the most highly recognized and successful painters out there. This piece is Portrait Underwater. Oil on canvas, 32 by 27 inches. This is titled Portrait Beard. I know that Peter has been very well supported by people like Saatchi. Get a chance to see a lot of New York's arty painting crowd out tonight. This piece is titled Dark Girl. 51 by 31. If you saw my Marlene Dumas report from the Museum of Modern Art, I talked about how both Peter and Marlena work from photographs, and also they use very thin staining and very atmospheric paint handling. You've got a whole gallery here of drawings. Attended shows I've been to recently. Yes, this is a very impressive opening. This piece is Maruga. Oil on canvas, it's 118 by 78 and 3/4 inches. Just heard some comments. I can't say who they're made by, but they kind of thought that this work and maybe his paint surface reminded them of Munch.
Right behind the ping pong player.
That guy, okay. Well, there's the artist. Thank you. Okay. Well, Peter's a little bashful. He decided he would didn't want to talk on camera. The show.
Awesome.
You like his work?
Very much so, yeah.
How are you doing?
I'm great, thanks. Yeah.
How's the work going?
Good. Hey.
You still living in Brooklyn?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Eric.
You're welcome.
All right. This is the big ping pong painting. It's kind of nice. It's got this very modernistic geometric grid behind there. He's got this figure in here. I was telling people, in certain ways, there are elements about the work that reminds me of R.B. Katai. Oh, we always seem to get a very attractive crowd down here. Gavin Brown. Oh, there's Jerry Saltz. This is maybe the most brightly colored piece in the show. Another painting that's about 118 by 78 inches. Definitely has kind of a oriental feeling about it. Really like the way that he contrasts the very brushy, drippy, uncontrolled sections of the painting with very crisp and well-defined sections. We got a very good example of his use of the very thin, washy, and drippy stains. Wow. Here's Bryce Martin. I think this is Chris O'Feely who's speaking with Bryce Martin here. Well, we're kind of in luck here. We've got an open spot in front of the painting. This is a titled jungle painting. Let's take a closer look here. Oh, this beige of the figure is just the raw linen. This piece is titled
A Box of Biscuits.
Music of the Future.
A Box of Biscuits.
78 by 118. Got a nice landscape. Maybe a beachscape. James Kalm reporting on Peter Doig's new paintings. Here at Gavin Brown's Enterprise. Thanks, Kate. Well, because it was such a noisy din when I was down here before, I decided to come back and give you viewers an unobstructed view of some of these paintings. And we'll have a little musical interlude provided by Miles Davis. Thank you.